I want to briefly walk you through nomenclature of a few different types of crosses that geneticists use. Most crosses start with pure breeding or homozygous individuals. You may have, for example, A1 over A1. And we've already looked at a couple of different types of crosses using hybrids. So here's a homozygote. If we cross a homozygote by a heterozygote, that doesn't have a particular name. But when we cross two heterozygotes together, we're looking at one gene, two alleles, that is the monohybrid cross. If we're looking at two genes and two alleles, as we've seen, an individual that's heterozygous at gene A and also at gene B, if we cross that individual to another individual of the same genotype, that's the dihybrid test cross. Now, there are a couple of other cross types that occur. One is called a backcross. And this is when, for example, you use organisms that are homozygous to produce a heterozygote. This is where the term backcross comes in. If you cross that organism to one of its parents back a generation, then that's considered a backcross. And it produces organisms of a particular ratio of genotypes that we'll look at later. Now, a backcross can occur with either parent. This could just as easily have been a backcross to the parent on the left, A1 over A1, instead of A2 over A2. One final cross type that's important to know about is a test cross. A test cross is defined as an individual that's homozygous for two or more alleles, so we'll say gene A and gene B on separate chromosomes. The test cross is defined as that genotype crossed to a dihybrid. Oops, that would be gene B. Dihybrid, so heterozygous at gene A, heterozygous at gene B. And this cross also is a special type of cross that we'll use later in the semester when we look at genetic mapping and recombination. So we have monohybrid crosses, dihybrid crosses, backcrosses, and test crosses. And we'll use all of these in class.